The world produces enough food to feed everyone. Yet the reality is, one in every seven people on our planet go to bed hungry each night. We've got to ask ourselves the question, why does hunger exist in a world with enough food for all?
I remember as a child being told to eat all my dinner because there were children starving in Africa. And it never really made a whole lot of sense to me how me eating my dinner would help them. And so I offered more than once to send it over. I was particularly keen to offer that when there was Brussels sprouts involved. I was not allowed to send my meal over, which seemed to me to be the most practical solution to the children starving in Africa. And because I couldn't understand how there was anything that I could do to help a situation that was so far away. As an adult, I've come to a really good understanding of how each one of us, our actions impact what happens to people all over the globe.
We're joining with movements across the world and in Australia with one key objective. Let's grow a better way towards a future where everyone has enough to eat, always.
And it's our job as compassionate people to make sure that the abundance of food on this planet is shared with everybody at the table. It is a simple goal for everyone to always have enough to eat.
Tonight, when you entered the door, you redrew your place in the world and you have been reassigned this evening a new life that falls under one of three categories. This dinner is a metaphor for how food and other resources are inequitably distributed in the world.
I'm feeling acutely embarrassed. We're sitting here at this dinner and we've had these beautiful meals brought out in front of us while our colleagues that we're sitting with were in the process of getting told that they weren't going to be eating much at all beyond rice this evening. And it's desperately embarrassing and difficult to sit here and eat in front of people who don't have the same as you.
So at the Oxfam dinner tonight, I opened up my little envelope, which told me I was a low income earner and I was from Afghanistan and I'd been run off my farm and I was starving.
So I'm on a high income and so I've had two of the three courses. It's actually quite confronting sitting up here and looking down at the others because they seem to be looking up at me as I'm eating.
Tonight I was in the low income bracket with a meal and you know, having to live off that or less, because I know tonight's meal was probably a little bit better than what most people around the world would get, was very humbling.
Everyone has hunger in common and everyone doesn't want to feel that pain. Being able to kind of compare and look at other people with amazing food and kind of getting angry. So it was nice to feel that anger so that I know how desperate people are in the world and how they want what I have.
When other people were getting food, we were having nasty thoughts because a lot of us have had a long day at work, but we were really hungry, so we were thinking, how can we get our hands on their steak? How can we get our hands on their food? And it really brought home to our table about what a lack of equality can do to societies. It creates a lot of civil unrest, so that's what one thing that really struck our table.
We were just given chocolate cake, and I was actually given quite a big slice, but I don't want to waste it.
Tonight I was Francisco, a 40-year-old farmer from Mexico, and I got to enjoy a middle-income meal alongside friends that were eating from a low-income. I'm a student at the moment, so I have to admit the middle-income meal was almost what I regularly eat, so it makes me think of how some people over-consume food or put too much emphasis on food, and perhaps if we all ate a little bit less, we could feed each other together.